This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create a flashable zip using Assayyed Kitchen from Boot.img and system.img. Now, you might find a flashable zip helpful when you need to port a custom ROM or when you need to flash your phone but either don't have a PC or your phone's USB port is bad, in which case you need to flash from recovery mode. Now, it's very important you know that you cannot flash this kind of zip from stock recovery. Okay, so you need to have a custom recovery installed. Custom recovery, like maybe TWRP, Philz, CWM and the rest, needs to be installed on the phone before you can flash a flashable zip like this. Okay, so now the first thing you want to do is to download Assayyed Kitchen. You can check our website for the download link, and then you need the boot.img and system image. Usually it's going to come like this. I just renamed it. Usually going to look something like this. So your boot.img and system.img should be placed in the, should be copied and pasted into the placed folder. Then you just launch Assayyed Kitchen, select yes if prompted. So let me just drag this here so you can. Alright, so okay, I think I should just expand the window so you can actually see a couple of things. Okay, how's this now? All right, okay, great. Now the first thing you want to do is to start your project. So you select one, which is starts creating project, and then you tap enter. Now it's asking me where I want to get the ROM from. I'll just tap enter since the default is place folder, so I'll just tap enter. And I have this stock image ROM, which is my boot image and the system image. I just type one, which is for this option I have here, and then enter. It's asking me to name the ROM, that is to name this project. I can just name it Hovatek ROM, and I tap enter. So now it's going to start by copying, then converting, then extracting. Now some people actually start with maybe a system.new.dat. okay, for that kind of situation, what you need to do is to use MTK extractor to convert from that format to the image format, then you can then bring it down to Assayyed Kitchen. And it's very important you have enough space on your PC, because you might run into one error, an error like clean up working folder or something like that, and you find that your system wasn't extracted. Now in that kind of situation, when you get that error, it means you either don't have enough space on your PC or you are trying to extract a signed image. Now take that again, if during extraction, like, you know, my extraction is taking a while, in this case that means it's actually working. By this time you should have gotten an error. Okay, if this is this if this applies to you, you should have gotten an error by now, an error like cleaning up working folder or something like that. Now if you get that error, it means one of two things. One, either you don't have enough storage space on your PC, or two, you are trying to unpack a signed image. If it's the former, of course you need to delete some stuff and make sure you have enough space on your PC before you proceed with extracting. And if it's the latter, that is the signed image, you first need to unsign the image. Now we have a guide on how to unsign an image at our forum, so just go to our forum, use the search bar, search for how to unsign or how to unpack a signed boot.img or system.img. okay, so after you unsign, you can then bring the image down to Assayyed Kitchen to start extracting. So this process often takes a while. You can see I've been on this for almost a minute now, if not more, and it's still copying, so I just need to be patient. Okay, so it has started extracting. I have extracting files from system image, and that is still extracting. You can just take a peek somewhere here. Yeah, you can see the system folder is here already, so that is in progress. I just need to exercise some patience, and so do you. Alright, so it's done extracting, and I have this option, what installer do you want? I usually just go with standalone, so I'll just type 2 and tap enter. ROM name, I can still maintain Hovatek ROM and tap enter. So you just wait while I generate the obliter script and other stuff you need. As you can see, there's the meta-inf already, and then system folder, of course. So you just have to wait a while. Okay, I had to actually pause because it was taking quite a while. So I have completed. Press enter to continue. So I just tap the enter button, and then I'll have all my projects details displayed here. Okay, all right, so you can just take a look here. You have your meta-inf, you have your system already unpacked, and you know, you can begin to make any modification you want, but I won't be making any modification. I can do dex, I can zipalign, I can, you know, add root, you know, whatever you want to do, you can just play around with the tool. Alright, so once you are done making any modification, it's time to repack. Okay, so I'm just going to select build ROM for flashing, which is option 7. So I just type 7 and I tap enter. Okay, so it's asking you how you want to pack, whether in DAT, RAW or zip. It really is up to you, but I usually just go for RAW, okay, because it creates, when you select RAW, it creates boot.img and system.img, just the way you put them into a side case in the first place. So from there you can decide to flash via fastboot, via SP flash tool, via whatever flash tool you want to use, whether for Mediatek or for Spreadtrum, because this guide covers both Mediatek and Spreadtrum Android phones. Okay, so with RAW, it gives you the image format which you can flash with, you know, it gives you more flexibility for flashing. Okay, so I just really go for RAW, which is option 3. All right, so for this device, you can now, it's asking me for the mount point for system. Now I have a couple of options here. I can choose to let the tool read from the kernel, which is from the boot image I supplied. From a device, I will have to connect a device, or manually I have to enter. Now I usually advise you go for the default option, which is from kernel, by just tapping enter. Now if while flashing the zip in recovery mode, you are getting some kind of cannot mount system, you are getting some mount errors, that means you need to find a way to get the phone's mount point, and then when repacking, you now go for manual and then enter the mount point. Now we have a guide on how to find out the mount point for your Mediatek or Spreadtrum Android phone on our forum. So just go to our website, search for how to find the mount point of a Mediatek or Spreadtrum Android phone, and that will show you how to do it. But that is only if you've tried the from kernel and that gives you an error when flashing. Okay, so I'll just go with default from kernel by pressing enter, and then it's going to detect the system pass from boot. Okay, so this is the mount point, which is, yeah, fairly accurate. Yeah, it's actually accurate. Yes, it's correct. Okay, so type name of your ROM. I can still give it Hovatek ROM. And I, of course, tapped enter there. And it's creating my Symlinks. So I just sit back. As I said, you don't have to go for RAW. I'm going for RAW because it outputs my files in, still in a zip, but it gives me my boot.img and system.img just the way I put them in the first place. That way I can flash through a host of tools or host of methods compared to when I have in zip format, which contains folders, or the DAT format. Okay, that's why I actually go for RAW. So I guess I need to be patient. Okay, now this is asking me if I want to expand my system. I usually don't advise you go with no, but if you know what you are doing, you can decide to expand your, the size of your system file. But I just know that is the file in the system file that will be created to the zip file. Okay, that'll be written to your, that'll be written to your flashable zip is what we're talking about here, not your phone's system partition size. Okay, so I don't have to increase the size of system.img. I can just leave it as default. So I just tap enter. Now that's giving me want to zip align my APK. I told you I don't want to make any modification whatsoever, so I will just go for no, which is zero, and tap enter. So you can see it's creating system.img. I actually prefer this method because I can decide to flash anyhow I want to flash. Oh, that seems to take a while. So I have converting sparse image to RAW EXT4. Yeah, I'm trying to be very patient when using this tool because of the size of system, of the system partition. System partition is about the, I think, largest, except you have a very large user data. That's about the largest partition you would have. So packing and unpacking could actually take a while, so you need to be patient. All right, okay, so it's asking me to type the name of the zip file. I could still maintain Hovatek ROM, of course you can change to whatever you want, and I tap enter. Now compression level, this is asking me how much I want to compress zip file, which will be the flashable zip which will be produced. I usually just go for default. You could decide to compress or reduce compression, but if you don't know what to do here, just select default, which is 5, by tapping enter. Okay, so packing is in progress, so you just have to sit back, grab a cup of coffee, and just watch the tool do its thing. Okay, this will take a while, so I'm just going to pause here and come back once it's almost done. So this is almost done after quite a wait. 97%, 98%. All right, so I'm 100%, and it's asking me if I want to sign the zip. I usually don't sign, so I just tap enter. You can sign if you want to, so I just press enter to. I tap enter to finish. So 100%, and I'm done. So to check your flashable zip, just open the ready folder, and of course you'll find the Hovatek ROM. And as I said earlier on, you can see in my case I have both image and system image because I selected the RAW option. So that's how to create a flashable zip for your Mediatek Spreadtrum Android phone from the boot image and system image using Assayyed Kitchen.